Y'all shall geology is where we learn all things marine science and how does it all relate back to you. Today we are talking about currents. So first are linear cells or linear circulations. These are the streaks or bumps that you see on the surface when looking at the ocean from an angle or in indirect sunlight. It's when strong winds blow in one direction, creating vertical opposing mini cycles of motion, which then pulls down water in the middle. If there were any floating objects nearby that were caught up by this, then they would stay on top of this motion. This simple phenomenon can surprisingly go a lot into the physics behind it. So if you want to learn more, click the video on the side or down in the comments. The next mechanism is called the Edmund spiral. It divides the water column into layers until the bottom of your average beach. And each layer carries a different water speed in a certain direction or velocity. As you go down, the direction would either go clockwise or counterclockwise, until a little bit is opposite the original surface direction, depending on which hemisphere you are looking from. Another way to explain this is with the term Edmund transport. Second to last has three separate phenomena. Upwelling, which has two, and downwelling has one. For upwelling, there is equatorial upwelling, which happens at the equator, where the northern hemisphere has a clockwise Edmund spiral, while the southern hemisphere has a counterclockwise Edmund spiral, causing a super speedway of water to be forced up and on top of the surface. As for coastal upwelling, wind direction usually go towards the North Pole, and typically the shore is on the left side, so the Edmund transport will go away from land and towards the ocean. There is coastal downwelling, which is the opposite of the scenario before. The winds go towards the south pole. The shore would be on the right, so the Edmund transport would go towards land. These events lead to significant biotic nutrient events. Putting all of these together creates gyres. Besides gyres, combining currents with other factors such as temperature, salinity, and density creating the deep water current. Made it this far into the video, then props to you, and I applaud your commitment. As a gift to you, I offer you to email me any questions that you have about this video, marine science careers, or any other thing, and I will reply to you ASAP. If you could do something for me, that would be great. By doing KBT. What I mean by that? Like this video, subscribe to my channel, and click the notification bell so you will get alerts when I post a new video. And as always, cheers and keep diving in.